Now, do while loop. Do while loop is the exit control loop. Means the condition is checked here, not here. So, you enter here. Even if the condition is false for the first time, you execute these instructions at least once. So, there is just a minor difference between while and do while and for actually. For and while, they are entry control loop. If the condition is false for the first time, you are not able to enter. You will not be allowed to enter. But in do while, you may be able, you are able to enter for the first time, even if the condition is false. You start, you initialize. Then you go to the body of the loop and the increment is done here. And the testing is done at the exit point. There is no testing here. See, in the for and while, the testing is done here itself. So, you execute these lines or body and then you test. So, if it is true, you go again. Otherwise, you come out. So, this is the first time you want to enter, say, while 4 is less than 1. Hello there. We know that 4 is not less than 1. So, this print will never happen. But, if we employ do while loop here, we say do while 4 less than 1. We know that this condition is false. But since we have employed do, this control will enter. This print will be printed, hello there. But the condition is false, then it will come out. So, at least one time this print will be printed. Hello there will be printed. So, there are certain occasions we want to at least run once the instruction. That is why we use the do while. The break and continue can be used with any construct, even with looping, even with decision control. You can use break, continue inside if also. So, this break and continue, they are depending upon your program or situation, it can be used.